Welcome to the video. Here we're going to spend a little time exploring an important subject, which is, I would say, that the global financial collapse. Now, I haven't been talking much about this. I sort of pepper this into all my videos a little bit here, you know, saying something's coming. It seems as though we have a clearer picture of when it's going to happen. I'm saying it's going to happen in March. This March. It could happen as early as March 4th through the 22nd, that sort of time frame. Various ways to have pinpointed that, very different than the economic gurus. I'm not an economist. But I know everybody's saying, how could this super rapid global collapse happen, which I've been talking about for years, and actually telling people about my whole life, as it's going to happen. And we just weren't sure when. And now I think we're getting very close to it. How could it happen all at once? Of course, derivative markets, okay. And so average person says, if there's a collapse, it's going to be a slow thing. No, what I saw in a dream, I was shown what's going to happen. It's going to happen with incredible rapidity. Incredible rapidity. Now, I was shown in the dream three collapses. The first two we recovered from. The third one we will not recover from. So, and looking at it in hindsight, I believe the first collapse was the 1929 stock market crash. The second was the 2008 recession, right? This third is going to be the final collapse. And what it's going to do is it's going to collapse all global currency, all fiat currency. There's no currency in this world that's backed by anything. It's just all paper. And this is the plan of the globalists, to replace paper money, fiat money, with digital currency, which they totally control. That will centralize the global bureaucracy. I've always said it's going to come like a thief in the night. It's going to come very fast and quick. And it'll happen because of the derivative markets, which is totally leveraged, okay? Totally leveraged. It's so badly leveraged, you know, there's no way banks can cover this. And it can happen through a black swan event of some type. Now, lots of ways I've been shown this to pinpoint it. And there are others too that are talking about this. I just was aware of this, that yeah, I'm not the only one who's saying it's coming in this March time frame. And it could happen very, very soon, within a couple of weeks actually. The situation could begin to implode, and it could implode very quickly, as a matter of fact. This is, you know, I'm just trying the best of my information to share. I don't have absolute certainty about a future event like this, but it certainly is looking like something like this could happen. I was shown a dream that the there's going to be a crash involving the Fed, but it's probably like global federal, a Fed, what do you call it? There's some Fed Reserve, sort of, there's a global type of money governance that is at play here. It's a global collapse. It's not a single country. It's the total global collapse, like dominoes. The whole thing will fall like dominoes. As a matter of fact, the 9/11 World Trade Center situation actually was a warning to the world what's going to happen to the global economy. Okay, it was a sign set up to warn the world. It symbolized derivatives, okay, the Twin Towers and World Trade Center Building Number 7 symbolized the collapse, symbolized how the economy will collapse because of derivatives, all right? Most people don't realize that the whole global financial situation is booby-trapped with derivatives. That when Glass-Steagall Act was taken off the books and replaced by the GLB Act, the alphabet soup of senators or something, representatives. That's when happened when Bill Clinton was president. It allowed the derivative market to go completely crazy. And it has not been fixed at all. And it's kind of like booby-trapping the buildings, where you get a black swan event, which was the plane going into World Trade Center. And people say, oh my gosh, that's terrible, 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 and terrible. And then the whole building suddenly collapses. And people are just freaking out, like, how could that happen? Well, with a little help from our friends, actually. So it was a way to symbolize what's to come. I think that these people give warnings to the world of what they're about to do in some way. And so the help that the, like, World Trade Building number 7, of course that was help to collapse. There's no question about it. A little fire in a building is not going to collapse supposedly one of the best built buildings in the world, okay? It was helped. It was complete demolition came down. That symbolizes the derivative problem, where we think that our financial system is built very solidly. And if there's some black swan event, like a plane going into the building, some sort of collapse of a currency somewhere, Venezuela's in big trouble right now, etc. But we say, yeah, that's terrible. What a tragedy. Let's get the people out, let's fix the building, etc. But what we don't realize is this derivative situation, a global derivative situation, will domino and will bring down the whole building very rapidly. I mean, just all at once, almost. That is what we're having to look forward to. And the World Trade Center, 9/11, actually was the symbol. It was the sign of Jonah, the sign of the whale. Those big, huge black buildings are like whales on land. And their collapse was the sign of what's to come in this global financial collapse based on the global market being booby-trapped by derivatives. Gives the leverage to take the entire system down, which is exactly what, you know, they want to happen. So I've been getting a heads up big time on this time frame we're in now, March 2014. Will it happen? I don't know. We'll find out. Again, I checked the sign that I had. I was shown to look for blossoms on the trees in a very specific location in a dream. I just went there yesterday. Well, the blossoms were there now. I said, oh gosh, it's time. It's time for this to happen. I saw the crash. I saw the flip over. It was like a FedEx truck or something. It symbolized the Federal Reserve and their involvement, their global involvement with the whole, you know, global financial situation. It would symbolize that level, high level of finance, okay, is going to flip. It's going to flip the world currency into digital currency. And that's why, you know, the Homeland Security had everything ready by October. They make sure they're all ready and prepped with all the hollow point bullets and all this kind of stuff to quell civil unrest, etc. That's why I said I had to be ready by President's Day, had to have right spiritual practice ready. All this stuff had to be ready to help deal with the crisis that's coming. I was shown last night that there's going to be a big push to help people with suicidal depression, because a lot of people will be dealing with that. Their savings are wiped out, their retirements are wiped out, college plans are wiped out. You know, it's a brutal, brutal thing that is potentially is coming. We will see if there's somehow some aversion to avert it, you would hope. But 9/11 did happen, okay? And that was very unexpected. It wasn't unexpected. I was shown it in a dream about 3 years prior. I was shown exactly what's going to happen. I couldn't understand it because it was so bizarre. I couldn't relate to it, but I knew something was going to happen, and when it happened, I knew exactly, that's exactly what I was shown in a dream. So it was planned. 9/11 was planned. And the level of, there's no secrets in the mind, really. And so somehow I was aware in a dream of what's going to happen. So this flipping of the global currency, demolishing of the fiat currency, flipping it over, crashing it, bringing about a new global currency, digital, is all planned. It's all planned in advance. They know what they're doing. And so don't expect that they won't do it. Just like 9/11 was planned and it happened, don't expect that this won't happen. Now, what to do about it? I don't know. I do know that right spiritual practice is the ultimate panacea. It's the ultimate panacea. And so that's the only thing that I suggest. is the most powerful exercise or practice anyone can do. You literally are able to use your will to deny the situation in your universe that says, I don't have that problem. It doesn't exist in my universe. Only the continuity problem exists in my universe. And this has the power to literally bring about your ascension, actually. Because if you're in a place where all these problems are, those problems don't exist in your universe. And so through the power of your will, that literally can manifest another place for you. We call it ascension. It might even be termed manifestation from your will, from your mind. We might be able to manifest another dwelling place for ourselves. Or maybe it's probably already been manifested by ourself. You see, we're all one. So we're all one. So our future self is the perfect self, the unified will self, which is the true self that's always been what we really are. And we can ask that future self to provide a place for us, and they will have already done it, as a matter of fact. Just like Jesus, for instance, is the symbol of our quote-unquote future self, which is really our awakened self, which is really our unified will self. And we can say, hey, Jesus, we're going to have this problem, and we want you to provide a place for us. And then Jesus will do that. It's the unified will self that is the self of all of us. That's the true self of all of us. We can literally ask that self to help out. And it's the same thing as asking the Holy Spirit to help out too, which is also the unified will of the Son, perfectly unified will of the Son with no projection at all. So I recommend looking at this thing from the spiritual angle. It's more powerful. I know all these people who bring this to light talk about you need to get protection, you need to get food, you know, it's the only way to, stock up. But no, I haven't done any of that. In California, we have earthquake stuff, in case there's a huge earthquake, so we have some food and stuff for a little while, I guess. But I would say right spiritual practice is the ticket. That's what I'm banking on, okay? So that's what I've been telling everybody for years now. Focus on right spiritual practice. I had another channel on YouTube, and I talked about the coming financial collapse a lot, and people are very interested in it. But then I said, look, the way to deal with it, you have to, right spiritual practice is the way. And then I started this channel and been focusing on that exclusively here, really. It's very important. That's where the power resides. The power resides in our will, a will that is free of projection. Right now, our will is not free of projection. We're still enmeshed in the continuity problem that we have. But our future self is free. It is free. It is free. All right? It's like, I'll tell you this, Jesus is like our future self coming back into the past. That's literally true. It's literally true. It's not separate from our future self. Our true self is one. The sonship is one. Okay? It's all one. So Jesus is like, went back in time, as it were. It's our future self coming back in time and warning us of what's going to happen and how our future self is going to help us. It's a very, very clear way of looking at it, actually. And not so coincidentally, I met my future self this morning in a dream, just this morning. And I saw that the future self is totally, totally safe. Everything's totally okay with my future self. I was shown some things last week about asking what's going to happen that were so amazing. You know, the Holy Spirit has got a great sense of humor. It points to things in such a clever, wonderful way that you just can't hardly believe it. You know, how what a great sense of humor it has. But the number 2-2 definitely was there. There's no question about it. Oh, I was outside a store, I can tell you this. You won't believe it, I know, but this is what happened. I'm outside a store waiting for some paint. And I said, Holy Spirit, I really want to know what's going to go on. I know, you got to tell me what's going to happen. When's it going to happen? Come on. And I got this sense of presence saying, go into the store and I'll show you. And so I said, what? Okay, whatever. I walked into the store and said, okay. Go over by this door here. I went over by the door and said, okay, now what do you see? I looked up and I saw this poster on the wall. It is the craziest poster you ever seen. It had planet Earth, okay. Standing on top of planet Earth was this man, kind of a bald-headed man with like a glasses and a mustache, very banker-esque looking man, okay? It was exactly what looked like a banker, a really powerful banker. And this banker had a can of paint and was pouring paint over the globe, and the whole top of the globe had this paint all poured over it. And what it looked like was, it looked like the planet was melting, like a meltdown of the planet. Okay. But that wasn't the most amazing part. The most amazing part was, of this whole thing, was this banker was wearing a tutu, a ballerina's tutu. Okay, and I saw that, I said, what in the world is that about? I said, I get the global meltdown. I could see that, the banker in a global meltdown, but why the tutu? Well, today, as I was watching something on the internet and it talking about potential crisis, and they're talking about number two and two. And I said, oh my gosh, the tutu. The tutu that this banker was wearing. So, 2 and 2 is 4, or it could be the 22nd, 2-2, March 22nd. So, you know, those kind of things, the total picture, like some kind of spiritual warning, you know, is just like amazing. Now, it was just an advertisement for some paint, but the relevancy of it was incredible. The timing and how in the world did something know that this poster was there, and it would clue me into exactly what's going to happen, and told me to go into the store and look right at the spot, and there was that poster, and I just said, wow, that is really something. So, very amazing, but something not to be overlooked, because it fits in with everything else, the dreams I've been having, and all the other information that people are giving out right now from different angles. There's lots of people from different angles, some from a biblical angle, some from an economic angle, some from a prophetic angle, some from the Holy Spirit angle. You know, there's a lot of different angles from different people pointing out the potential for a derivative global financial collapse coming this March. The Ides of March, the 15th of March, is when the Syrian war started, civil war in 2011. And, you know, beware the Ides of March. I mean, something could get started on the 4th of March and be snowball. The global collapse could happen, you know, I don't know how long it would take, but I've said it could happen just boom, just that quickly. Banks would fail. Things would be shut down. You know, banking holiday declared, martial law imposed, all that stuff could come about extremely rapidly. So, catch our breath over this. Hopefully nothing will happen, but I think I guess I'm the first one to make this connection between 9/11 and the global collapse, and how it's symbolizing the super unexpected rapid collapse of the banking system due to derivatives. And of course, the World Trade Center was symbolic of global finance, right? Global commerce, global finance. That's what it symbolized. So what it's symbolizing is this super unexpected, incredible rapid collapse of the world financial system based on a black swan event, a couple black swan events, you know, certain pressures brought to bear upon the world financial situation. And those pressures could come from a lot of different directions right now. I know Venezuela is in a state of collapse right now. So is the Ukraine, right? There are troubles in the world right now. Syria is still in trouble. And all over the place, there are weak spots, vulnerable spots that we don't hardly realize. Currency of a lot of countries is actually in drastic problems, and so it could come out of the blue, like the planes for the World Trade Center, just like, well, you know, what? And here comes another one. It's like two there and one at the Pentagon. Penta 5. This is really the 15th year of this century. Starting, if you start 2000 and count that, 2000, 2001 is 1 year. This is in the 15th year of this century. So many things are coming together right now that I think people realize that something could be up. And we know the black swan refers to a very unexpected event that has unintended consequences, like that plane hitting the World Trade Center. Those planes had unintended consequences, didn't it? Actually led to war, didn't it? Absolutely. Look what happened since 9/11. It's like a different world right now. So the that also symbolized, look, this global financial collapse is going to lead to a different world. Big time, big time. So we keep in mind that the ascensional power of our mind, of our will, when the will is unified, or when we turn to our future self and ask for help, humbly say, future self, you know, I know that you are what I really am. I'm just in a dream, imagining I'm something else. So I'm waking up from the dream, and I ask you to go back into the dream and appear in that dream in the form of help for me, to help me get awakened from this dream, you know, awakened from the dream of projection. And that's very powerful. So, what to do at this point? I'm not sure if I'm going to switch gears or what's going to happen. I'll meditate on that. But the Holy Spirit is certainly getting my attention big time that something is coming. Now, here's another huge indicator, okay? Huge. It just so happens that I've completed all my work on my job. There are no more jobs. It's an amazing thing. Never happened before. Simply, we have no work. We have no jobs. Everything is put away. Everything is neat and clean. Everything is accomplished. And literally, on March 3rd, I don't have any work. And my whole future is completely open. Amazing. Amazing. The timing of that is simply incredible. I've noticed. I said, wow, this is really amazing. There are other things as well. A relative was brought over here from another country. I thought they needed to get out of there before this problems came, and they managed to get out of there. So it's kind of like all my business has been completed just in time, which another factor, I've always just right on time. And so completing all of that work and you know, just right on time, for me it means that something is coming. And as far as no other work showing up for me, you know, that may very well show that there may be, you know, some sanctuary situation that our future self is going to come back and help us. Well, maybe perhaps with a rapture, the Judeo-Christian tradition, there are some who are speaking saying the rapture is going to happen sometime in March. And it could very well be right that some sort of ascensional situation through, because of future self, unified will, non-projected will, is capable of manifestation. Of manifesting, we're all manifesting now. We're manifesting a dream of delusion, but that unified will is capable of manifesting a better situation for us, where right spiritual practice is easy to deal with, and sidestepping this whole, you know, global meltdown, this global financial meltdown. So, I don't popularize this too much as far as on the internet on. Like I could, you know, present it in such a way that they would get a lot of attention, etc. But that brings a different mindset, okay, of people. I don't really want to do that. I don't know if that's the right thing. Because right spiritual practice is the way that I'm advocating. I'm not advocating anything else. People say, what do I do? I need to stock up on my, you know, ammo and stuff and get ready for a firefight and all this stuff. Well, you know, you do what you got to do, but I say right spiritual practice is the way that I'm going to go about it, and it's the way that I advocate for everybody else to go about it too. But very few see the wisdom in that. Very few see the wisdom in that. So I don't like to fearmonger too much, but I really believe that there's a problem coming, and it's no question. It has to do with derivatives. It has to. It has to. It's the only way the whole thing could come down that fast. You know, people have been thinking, what? Scratching their heads thinking, how in the world could it all happen like that? It's just not possible. Well, it is possible. Look at the World Trade Center situation. I look at 9/11. No way those buildings come down like that without some help. No way. No way, no way, no way. Especially World Trade Center numbers, building number 7. No way in the world. There's never been a fire in any skyscraper that's built to incredible code requirements, etc., by the top architects and structural engineers in the world. There's no way in the world that a little fire and some carpet and some office, you know, is going to cause the whole building to come down, collapse on itself like a controlled demolition. It's utterly absurd. So, the derivative market has been rigged, in my opinion. I was shown this in a dream. It's very complex. I was shown how it's going to work, but it was so complex, I couldn't understand it at all. It was just Byzantine, you know, in its complexity. And it has been rigged, all intentionally rigged to fail. It has been rigged to fail. It's just a matter of a black swan event to blame it on. Okay, they're just waiting for an event to blame it on and say, this caused it. The airplane caused it to fall. What about World Trade 7? Oh, well, some debris came in and started a little office fire. That's what caused it to fall. You know, that they can blame it on the black swan event. That's what caused everything to collapse. Not that they rigged it all with the derivatives to cause it to collapse. So, these are the times we live in. And just pray to your future self, really. Whatever you want to call your future self, it's all one. It's all unified will, okay? The sonship is one, okay? It's not separate, this. It's all one. It's all one. Reality is all one. So you can call your future self whatever you want to call it. You know, whatever you're comfortable with your tradition. The fact is that it is spirit, that it is unified will, okay? There's no projection there. There's no dream of separation there. All right, and ask that future self to help you, absolutely to help you. Ask the Holy Spirit to help you, which more of a, you know, formless way of relating to your future self, which your future self is really formless. Spirit doesn't have form like we think form. No. So if you want to go formless like that, more abstract, the Holy Spirit. If you have some reification because of idolatry, etc., that we've been dealing with, you can reify the future self as a, concretize them as some person. That's fine for right now. Just ask your future self, say, future self, you're on, you're up to bat, it's your time now, do your thing. And I'm sure they're thrilled to help us, absolutely thrilled. Could you imagine your future self, how happy they are to come here and help us at this time? Because that's how we get to there. Because our future self has been helped by the Holy Spirit. It's a reversing time, it's a time thing, you know, it's a way of turning time around. Our future self is already there. We're just dreaming, we don't know it. See, when we wake up and realize we never left. we never separated at all. So the future self is already there, it's already perfect. So we can ask them to come into our dream like that. Dream of time. Absolutely we can. So we'll see. I mean, 9/11 again, I was very much aware of it. In fact, about, you know, was it 60 days before or 30 days or some period of time, I started to severe panic attacks all day. And I was absolutely scared out of my mind that some incredible vicious attack was going to happen. And every day it got worse and worse and worse, and I couldn't shake it. And then on the day that it happened, I was told to go to a park and sit there in serenity, and then driving back home, I heard about it. but it was so serene, I just said, okay. I didn't pay any attention to all the hysteria or anything, panic. Just passed it by. I went to a beautiful sanctuary, as a matter of fact, is where I went to on that day. Beautiful, beautiful sanctuary. Met some beautiful people there. It was very nice. Then I came home and I heard in the news, and I just said, ah, that's it. I was very relieved because it wasn't an attack against me. You know, I've just been shown what's going to happen. So, events like this, you know, do reverberate in time-space. They reverberate in time-space. The intentions reverberate. The intentions are known. No, nobody can hide their intentions. Mind is one. Now, again, helping people with their depression. There'll be a lot of suicidal depressives out there. And we're going to have to be able to help people in some way, some fashion, with what's to come. Have to be very stable to do that yourself, but it might be for a while. It might be very much troublesome here for the next 3 years. Things run in cycles of three, I find, right now for some reason. Okay, so there you go. So a little update on the situation here. This would be a very interesting ride forward. Don't forget about your future self. Don't forget about the Holy Spirit. Don't forget about right spiritual practice. Don't forget about that you can say, declare, I don't have a financial crisis problem. I have a continuity problem. That is the assertion of your will. And what you will, you manifest. So when you insist you don't have any of these problems, you can manifest a whole world. You can manifest a dwelling place, literally, that is free of all these problems. And then the only problem is the continuity problem, which is then easily dealt with by having the vision of oneness there. Easy. And then that's it. You are literally enlightened, you would say. You're abiding in the enlightened condition, in the free, liberated condition. At which point you could help those out who are still in this, dealing with this paradigm of problems. So, very juicy time, very interesting time. And like I said, if I don't have any other work, that means there's something else that I'm going to be working on coming up. That is for sure. I'm a workaholic, and it just doesn't suit for me to have no work. Amazing times, right? Amazing times. So tomorrow's March 2nd, and we will see what March has to hold in store for us. But don't obsess about any of this stuff. Stay with right spiritual practice. Stay with it. I don't have a March problem. I have a continuity problem, right? I don't have a world problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a global financial collapse problem. I have a continuity problem, okay? And the vision of oneness is the only value there is. These are declarations, these are assertions from your will. Your will, and you know, guides your mind, tells your mind what you want. Your mind manifests for you what you have told it to manifest for you. So by doing these declarations, you are literally, at some level, you are manifesting a whole realm for yourself, as a matter of fact. It could be subtle at this point. But that subtlety, you could become less subtle into the fact that you actually can find yourself dwelling in such a situation. That's a real spiritual alchemy right there. Okay, so keep your spiritual exercises going. All right, thanks for watching. That's it for this one.